Hi, this is David Atkinson with City National Foreign Exchange, and this is Global Perspectives. You know, I guess it's because school has started, probably, but I was actually looking at some academic papers over this last weekend. I was trying to sort of figure out all the stuff that's going on with negative interest rates and low interest rates and things of that sort. You know, part of this, it sort of came out of the Jackson Hole Fed Summit in Wyoming. You know, there are a couple of Fed speakers there that really sort of said things that really spoke to me in a sense. You know, they were talking about the fact that why are we trying to lower rates when the business leaders that they're talking to are not complaining about high rates? Yes, business investment actually is low right now, but it's because of uncertainties and things like the trade war rather than the cost of capital. That's just simply not the problem. You know, and as I was doing a little bit of research, I came across a couple of academic papers. We have the links and the text as well. And one of these is from Princeton by a couple of economists, and they were talking about this concept of the reversal interest rate. And I was like, what is the reversal interest rate? Well, technically, this is an interest rate below which the effects of monetary policy, instead of helping an economy, could actually hurt an economy. Now, it's one thing to have low interest rates that essentially don't do much to help an economy. It's another thing to have interest rates that can actually get so low they can hurt an economy. And the idea behind this is really more of the fact that it's the banks that are getting hurt, and the entire financial infrastructure then suffers because of that. Yeah, banks can't necessarily make money on loans because, you know, businesses are not taking out loans because of the cost of capital, it's because of the uncertainty. But banks can't really make much money on the deposit side either. And so the whole financial system tends to contract in a situation like that. That is really what's happening in Europe, where the banks really are struggling right now. There was another paper out there that talks about the various tools that central banks have. And it sort of focused on the fact that you do have things like quantitative easing probably being more effective than these lower negative interest rates. There's a caveat, though, is that the quantitative easing needs to be temporary. It needs to come back. And if you leave a big, huge balance sheet out there with central banks, then that tends to increase the risks as well. It leads me to my view, which is something else I heard market participants talking about this week, which is the idea of a Bretton Woods conference for interest rates. You may remember towards the end of World War II, there was the Bretton Woods conference that really established a framework for currencies with gold at the center of it. You know, and that actually collapsed in the early 70s. But the idea here is maybe we need to get central banks together really to sort of coordinate more on the interest rates, because otherwise it's just everybody's getting to low interest rates, which can be harmful, frankly, to an economy. Unfortunately, I'm not hopeful that this is going to happen, but it's a good idea. Thank you very much and have a great weekend.